He cut the sole off the boot and put it in the high grass near the grave on the edge of a hole that was half overgrown. "That will do," said he. "Now the chimney sweep may come." They both sat down and waited, and it was not long before the devil returned with a small bag of gold in his hand. "Just pour it in," said the soldier, raising up the boot a little. "But that won't be enough." The black one shook out all that was in the bag. The gold fell through, and the boot remained empty. "Stupid devil," cried the soldier. "It won't do. Didn't I say so at once? Go back again and bring more." The devil shook his head and went, and in an hour's time came with a much larger bag under his arm. "Now pour it in," cried the soldier, "but I doubt the boot won't be full." The gold clinked as it fell, but the boot remained empty. The devil looked in himself with his burning eyes and convinced himself of the truth. "You have shamefully big calves to your legs," cried he, and made a wry face. "Did you think," replied the soldier, "that I had a cloven foot like you? Since when have you been so stingy? See that you get more gold together, or our bargain will come to nothing." The wicked one went off again. This time he stayed away longer, and when at length he appeared, he was panting under the weight of a sack which lay on his shoulders. He emptied it into the boot, which was just as far from being filled as before.